throws will be made and dreams will come true in the next 2 weeks. Who's going to capture our imagination by becoming the Cinderella of this year's big dance? Nick and I'll find out starting in today's game between the Prairie View A&M Panthers and the Baylor Bears.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
The Bears should have an easy one tonight, Dick. How do they keep this team from sneaking up on them, though?
Hey, here's my keys for them tonight. First, the point guard has to be the floor general. It's up to him to ensure that his team executes and has efficiency on both sides of the floor. Second of all, be strong with the ball. Turnovers can be the story here tonight, so protect that basketball. And finally, play every defensive possession like it's the last.
I think you're dead on, Mr. Vitale. Let's see what happens. Let's get this one started. He strokes it off the rim and no good. Both teams looking to get things going here. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. With the J. Off the mark. On the outside, got a wide open look. For two, in and out. Leans in, and he scores despite the half. There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
It's definitely a mismatch.
And now there's a whistle and a foul. Oh, and you talk about a happy group of fans. Listen to this crowd.
Oh, there's all kinds of people standing and cheering and going wacky.
High post flashes for the ball handler. And our trifecta for the Knights. Aaron scores it, and he's fouled. So, and one opportunity here. He is going to the line. It goes in.
Pressure that basketball.
Got some room. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
For three, he drains the bucket. The center with the ball. He drains the shot. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. They work it around the perimeter from beyond the arc. Questionable shot selection there.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. With a jump hook. Doesn't go. The point guard gets the ball. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Tries for two.
I'd say great job protecting the basketball, getting deep post position, and the jump hook is so effective.
This place will go senseless, Dick, if they can get a stop. The small forward takes the pass. Looks at the three. Way off target.
Spacing.
Shoots off the rim and no good. Dick, these two teams in this first half of this tournament game have shown that they definitely belong in the big dance, and both of them look like they could dance all the way to the end, maybe.
I tell you, two teams well coached, two teams who understand about offensive and defensive efficiency and understand to minimize fast break opportunities. This game is coming down to who can execute better in their half-court game, because you're not going to get any easy layups tonight.
Looking for a good shot. Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. two. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
He's a one-man show at the moment. He can't get any help from his teammates.
Moving it around the perimeter. For two. They still don't score.
The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He just heaves it up there. Way off target. At the end of the first half, the Bears lead by six. Best play of that half. Let's take another look. Did a masterful job of grabbing the boards in the first half, Mr. Vitale.
Wow, I'll tell you, Brad, these guys are so well coached. The coaching staff preaches the importance of winning the rebound battle. And then they went out there and they just did that.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I can hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Erin.
Try to go inside.
The power forward takes the feed. Goes up for two. Oh, yes. They move it into the front court. Looking for a good shot. For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket. I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great hit. Ooh, look at the shot block, but he got some contact. Nice hops.
The point guard gets the pass.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad. You better get rid of it, Brad.
Here's the three ball. Off the rim and no good. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
They look to get it to the inside. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, you think?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
And have it stolen away. Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork beating to the spot.
When I hear Big 12 basketball, I think tough defense. Half court, pound the ball inside offense.
Hey, teams like Texas, Kansas, Oklahoma are usually on top of the standings because they can play that style.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Erin Andrews.
Well, guys, down here on the sidelines, there is such intensity from both benches. Both coaches are emphasizing shot selection and defensive stops. So important here in the second half.
Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind me because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Now the high screen. It's good. Set up, Dick. That brings the lead to 8 points, Dick.
But 8 points doesn't secure a win at this point, Brad.
He looks for the bomb. Whoa, not a good decision to take that shot.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Cross court.
Dump it inside.
He's got an open look for the shot. Looking to move it around the perimeter. They work it around the perimeter. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Tinsley is pretty fired up and excited.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you should be afraid to show your emotions.
The power forward takes the pass. Tries for two. For the bucket. He comes up empty. Easy one. This Start the Bus moment, courtesy of our good friends at State Farm. That's a matter of clock management, isn't it, Dick? Wow, Dick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
And the clock stopped with a foul.
Nobody likes this part of the game when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
And yet another foul. Oh, and you talk about a happy group of fans. Listen to this crowd.
Oh, there's all kinds of people standing and cheering and going wacky.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Trying to hang on here. And the clock stopped with a foul. And yet another foul. He goes to the line for the first time. Makes the front end of the one and one. Makes it. Timeout.
Sometimes timeouts can take teams right out of their rhythm, Brad. Let's see what happens here.
And all the way on the baseline, now the kick out fires it. He seems absolutely adverse to taking any good shots right now.
And with that, his teammates may be getting a little bit frustrated.
Working it around the perimeter. To pick up the defense here now.
Up and inside.
Hawkins handles the pass. Dick, you said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's going home.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about. And that was the difference in the game.
Baylor Played exactly the type of game they need to get past their first round opponent.
Mr. Nessler, if they can execute the way they did today, are you kidding me? Nobody will stop them heading into the second round.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.